What's your story and how did you get to where you are today?
So I have started as a student in Karnataka, JSS Medical College, one of the prestigious institute in Karnataka. And after getting graduated from that college, I have procured a seat in GMC, that is Guntur Medical College. And teaching became my passion once I have joined my Guntur Medical College in physiology.
Who influenced you to become a professor?
I have seen my professors like Dr. Siddesh and Dr. Vasant Kumar. Those were best professors, like I mean to say, in the field of surgery. And actually I took this profession because of my parents. They are also doctors, and my grandparents, like my grandfather's brother, he's a MS general surgeon, and my grandfather's sister, she's a gynecologist, and she did MRCOG from London. And there are about 60 doctors in my family, close relatives. So obviously I was inclined to do this medical profession.
Describe the biggest challenge you have ever had to face as a professor.
Yes, there are many. I cannot say one, because most of the time it comes from the other end of the classroom, that is see, poor performance. The students are unable to perform to their potential, and motivating them and bringing them to the successful level was the biggest challenge I have always faced. Like every year I will be facing the same thing.
For what in your life do you feel most grateful?
Yes, for everything I will be very grateful. To have such a wonderful family, parents, children, wife and my daughter, and all the students who give a lot of respect to us, and they always look forward at us whenever they have a doubt or whenever they are in dilemma regarding the subject or some aspects of life. So everything, I always feel grateful for everything, whatever I have in my life.
What advice would you give to your younger self?
Yes, that not only for me, the same thing I'll also give to the students who are there in our college or whoever I face usually, is I tell them that studies is not everything. I tell them that they have to spend time, a quality time with their parents. They have to concentrate on the studies, and apart from these two things, they have to maintain their good health and public relations also. That means they have to spend more time in the playgrounds, they have to do some exercise, and they should also spend quality time with their friends also. So everything is essential in life. The education is only part of life, not everything. That is what I would like to give the younger generation, as well as I would have spent, if it is advice to myself, then I would have spent more time with my friends. I would have communicated better with my teachers. I should have done all those things. So I will tell the same advice to even to my students.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
What's your